Well, good evening. It's good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight. We're just so blessed, y'all. I don't think this church really realizes how blessed you've been over the years to have some of God's finest here. And tonight is no exception. You know, the Bible says whenever we have a guest, whenever we entertain a guest, they're a gift to us. And folks, just coming out of the Christmas season, we've talked a lot about gifts. Well, this is part of your New Year's gift, is the concert tonight. And we're so delighted to have Karen and New River. And I was going to read some of their bio for you, but it's a little long. Five-time Grammy nominated. Seven-time GMA Dove Award winning, 30 years in the music industry. Karen was inducted into the Gospel Music Hall of Fame in 2018. She was a singer for the popular Rex Neeland Singers for a decade. They've been around the world, U.S., Canada, Israel, Central America, and Europe. They've been in the Gaither Homecoming video series. I was going to ask you, how many songs, well, there you are, how many songs have you written or co-written? You have any idea? You don't know? 40. 40. I've never written one song, and you've written 40. Folks, we're so blessed. I really think we need to have a word of prayer before we begin, just to pray for them and pray that this experience will be as special to them as it will be to us. Amen. So let's pray together before we begin. Father, we just thank you for this night. We thank you for these who've come out tonight to just worship you. We thank you for Karen Peck and New River and sending them our way tonight. Lord, we're so blessed, and we give you glory. We give you honor. So, Lord, bless them tonight. Lord, I know how it is to travel, and sometimes you get weary, and sometimes you just kind of wish you could be home with your feet propped up in front of the fire. But, Lord, tonight you've sent them here to minister to us. So I pray that the blessing will be as much in their favor as it is in ours. So bless them tonight as they share your word. Lord, let your Holy Spirit fall in this place. Let your presence be so powerful, Lord, that lives are impacted, and if it be your will, lives will be changed. Lord, we love you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you do me a favor and give a big Mims Conroe welcome to Karen Peck and New River?
Well, good evening. Heart's been weary, my soul's been dry, and now I'm desperate for the water. I've been so empty, just getting by, and now I'm desperate for the water. Wash all over. the reason I can sing. Hope for my tomorrow, He's my everything. Jesus is the reason I can sing. He gives me hope, joy, peace, strength. Joy. Jesus is a reason for my joy. Even in the midnight, my strength forevermore. Jesus is a reason for my joy. He gives me hope, joy, peace, strength.
So pray now.
in Jesus' name. Okay, from this side of the church over, I'm going to sing that again. And if you really believe that there is strength and there's power in the name of Jesus, I want you to say amen as loud as you can. There is strength and power in Jesus' name. It's good. Okay, now this side over. There is strength and power in Jesus' name. Now everybody. There is strength and power in Jesus' name. Amen. So pray now. And I love what this song talks about, where it talks about he's to still pray even if you're in the middle of the storm. And this past Friday night, we were coming from Louisiana and headed to Texas, and we were literally heading toward the tornado, toward the storms. And about 2:30 in the morning, our phones went off, and it said, a tornado warning, take an emergency shelter immediately. And so our bus driver never pulls off on the side of the road, but he said just for some reason, of course he couldn't see the road because of the wind and the rain, but he pulled off on the side of the road, and we know that was the Lord prompting him to just pull the bus over, and the bus was rocking back and forth, and we didn't know at the time, but the tornado was about a mile ahead of us, and so we didn't know at the time just how severe it was. We just knew it was bad. And all the years, it's actually 40 years this year that I've been traveling, and we've had New River 29 of those 40 years, but I don't think I've been that afraid in a long time, just being on the bus, because there's nowhere for us to go. And I just remember as we were looking out at in the front of the bus, all of us were up except Ricky. My husband was still in the bed asleep. Grant over here said he was Jesus in the boat. So Ricky's asleep in the, you know, Ricky's always the first one up. He said, oh, y'all have little faith. He said, we're going to be fine. And so, but we were in the front of the bus, and we just started praying. And I felt so helpless. But then as I started thinking, you know what? I've been saved most of my life. We have to believe. We have to believe that the Lord has us in the middle of the storms, literally in the middle of the storms. We've been through a lot of life storms as well. And there's times when my husband was diagnosed with cancer almost 5 years ago, we were so devastated that honestly, I had to keep going and singing. And I would get up here and I just feel so desperate for God to move. But you know what? It's so good to know that even when we're in the middle of the storm, that Jesus is still Lord and Jesus is still on the throne, and we are going to make it. So if you're in the middle of a storm here tonight, please know that Jesus loves you and he cares for you. And I wasn't going to do this song right now, but I want to do this next song. A young lady came to me and was sharing with us about how a few years ago, back 2002, I believe it was, she was involved in a hostage situation at a store, a convenience store. There were three people that held hostage, and eventually all three were shot, including her. And it was just, one of them was killed, and it was just devastating. I thought, well, that's real problems right there, y'all. And she's here tonight, and this was one of the songs. We haven't done this in a while. Ricky, cue up Special Love. But we haven't done this song in a while. I don't even know if we remember the words, but we'll just sing through it. But I want us to come down off this platform, if it's okay, because this young lady said that this was one of the songs that got her through that hard time. So I just want you to know that I am so thankful for the love of Jesus. He is the only love, the only true love that we will ever, ever experience. Listen. help me make it through. Lord, I need to feel that kind of love that only comes from you. If you'll just squeeze my hand, let me feel you by my side. You said you'd never, never leave me. Lord, you'd always be my guide. Let the storm
say something right quick. Jesus loves me. We had a lady come up last year, and she said, she was an older lady, and she said, I was in the hospital, and she said, I didn't have anybody to come and visit me. And she said, I was all by myself. And she said, all I could think about was that song, Jesus Loves Me. She said, I sang it so many times when I was a little girl. But she said, now that song means so much to me. And we sing it as a child, but just think about how much Jesus loves us now. He's loved us our whole life. So if you feel like that nobody loves you here tonight, Jesus loves you. And hold on to that and keep believing that Jesus loves you. Amen.
Well, here we go. Our program is turned upside down. Can y'all tell? We usually try to have a set program, but it's flipped upside down. So here we go. Well, are you glad to see my sister here tonight, Susan Peck Jackson? Whew. We love it when it's like that, y'all. I'm telling you, we are having church already. And please know these altars are open all night long. And please come and pray. I know that you've been coming out of a Bible conference, and I know it was beautiful. It was wonderful all week. And so, and we just want you to know that these altars are still open. So please feel led to come if you need to. We'll pray with you, whatever we need to do. We just want things to be right with you and the Lord. And we just pray that the Holy Spirit will prompt your heart. If you're here and you don't know Jesus as your Savior, you're our special guest. We want you to leave here tonight knowing that Jesus is Lord of your life. And so, amen. There you go. And Susan and I guess we can go up here and we'll go back up here and in the light. But Susan and I are so opposite in personalities. Y'all, she's just like Daddy. Daddy only talked when he had something to say, and Daddy's in heaven now, but Susan only talks when she has something to say. So what she just said, that was a big deal for her, and that's when it blesses me so much. And you know, and so she's like Daddy. She talks, you know, only talks when she has something to say. And I want mama. I talk until I have something to say. I mean, you stay with me long and I'll finally hit that subject. But I'm so proud of her. And her husband, David, builds steel guitars for a living. Their son, Joseph's in his last year of college with Toccoa Falls Online College. So we're so, so thankful. Susan, my husband, Ricky, and I started New River 29 years ago. On New Year's Eve, our pastor and a pastor friend prayed over us and we dedicated New River to the Lord. So we're thankful to still be out here after all of these years. And Ricky's in the back, and we've been married 30 years, y'all. But he is a 5-year cancer survivor. So we praise God for that. That's Ricky. I want to go ahead and just tell y'all, and I probably have told this at Mims before, but this is a true story. I mean, we live in Georgia, just an hour north of Atlanta. And Atlanta kind of reminds us of the Dallas area, Houston area, that kind of thing. And so people will hear this accent if we're out of the state of Georgia. They'll say, girl, where are you from, Texas? And I'll say, no, I'm not from Texas. So if y'all ever want to know what you sound like, this is it. So I'm sorry, but there you go. But we're blessed. We're flipped upside down. We are so thrilled to have this young man with us. The pastor talked about Grant this morning, and we're very blessed to have Grant with us. He's been with us 2 years this March, and 2 weeks ago yesterday, he got married. Yes. And he just got back from Hawaii on his honeymoon, and this is his first weekend back, and we're so blessed to have him with us. He's from Jasper, Alabama, but he married a Georgia girl, so now he's a Georgia boy. How about that? How about it for Grant Gibson? And I want to say, as I've said this, I've been so blessed this morning. Fred, the choir was outstanding. I mean, honestly, I don't remember when I've heard any. I have not heard any better than what we heard this morning. And wow. And then the pastor and pastor's wife, you can always tell a good church by its pastor and pastor's wife. When you walk into a church and people are friendly to you, you know there's a friendly pastor. And so you all have a wonderful pastor and pastor's wife. I know you know that. They did not tell me to say that. But thank you all so much. You've been so sweet. So over here is my daughter, and I'm so blessed. Carrie is 23 years old. She just graduated from Liberty University Online, and I cannot say enough good things about Carrie. She's a great organizer. She loves the Lord. She listens to preaching all the time and music. And I told her the other day she's my hero. And I am so thrilled and honored to be her mother. And how about it for my girl, Carrie Faith? Then over here is our son, Matthew. Matthew's 27 years old. We've been to Israel twice with our friends, the Isaacs. We're going back this coming June with the Isaacs, the Bowlings, and Tim Menzies, and we're excited about that. And Matthew, tell them what happened the first trip that we went to Israel.
Well, on the second day of our trip, we went to the Mount of Beatitudes where Jesus gave the Sermon on the Mount. And I was able to ask my girlfriend if she would marry me there. And she said yes. So we got married June of 2018. So that's a little bit about our story. Yeah.
Yes. Now, Matthew has a degree in religion, history minor from Liberty Online. His wife's name is Presley. She's from Kentucky. And, y'all, she works our product table, and she's so beautiful. We love her so much. They have their own coffee company called Solid Ground Coffee, and they roast every week from Guatemala. So everybody's raving over that coffee, and we're very blessed. How about it for Matthew Gooch?
attendeth my way. When sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well. My soul, it is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul.
Can you say amen? My gracious. I want to tell you the truth. I don't like these guys a little bit. I like them a lot. Who knows what I'm talking about? And amen. Karen Peck, I've observed several things about you today, and one of them is, and we'll not get into all of this, and if you ask me later, I don't even know that I'll tell you what I mean, but you are a genius, and I could name you 100 reasons why I've already been able to discern that, and it is a blessing, and I mean that as a compliment, so you should say amen, all right? But man, what a blessing. Amen? What a real, real, real blessing. And I mentioned this morning, and they mentioned earlier that the family and I have known Grant for quite a while, and it's always a joy, Grant, to be around you. Your spirit, your heart, you just carry yourself wonderfully and represent the Lord well, and it's good to have you here with everyone. We're going to receive an offering tonight, and I want to really, really challenge every one of us tonight to really dig deep and to give. Now, I understand. I recognize it. We've been taking offerings every service for the past couple of days. I realize it. I get it. But you know what? I know God's not broke. Amen? What I know is God owns it all. He owns a cattle on a thousand hills. And what I want to really challenge you to do and all of us to do this evening, as we try to do every time we take the offering, is to really be prayerful and to really consider, Lord, what would you have for us to give? What would you have for us to do? Now, the offering receiving tonight is to go for Karen Peck and New River to be a blessing to them. I know I've said it at least 5 times this past week, but I've got to say it again tonight because, you know, somehow or another, we've got to really get this in our heart and understand biblically what we're doing tonight. I've heard pastors say that, you know, we're taking an offering to cover expenses. Or they may say something like this, we're receiving an offering to defray expenses. And I got to be honest, every time I hear that, I sort of cringe. And the reason that I do is because what that would imply is that these guys are a liability. And I want you to know they're not a liability. According to the Bible, they're an asset and they're a gift from God to the church. Amen? So we're not taking an offering to defray expenses. No, no, no. We're not taking an offering to cover expenses. What we're doing is we're giving everyone in the room that's willing to participate an opportunity to invest in the kingdom, in kingdom work, and in the ministries and the lives of these that are here tonight, sent by our Lord to be a blessing to us as they continue to go and be a blessing to others. Who's listening to what I'm saying? Say amen. Amen. So I want to challenge you. I'm not ashamed to ask you or to ask myself. I'm not embarrassed to ask us to pray and say, Lord, what would you have us to give? I've often told the story of my son several years back. He was a good bit younger. He had a red Velcro wallet, one of those trifold Velcro wallets. And we had announced on Sunday morning that night we were taking an offering. And so he was getting ready in his room, and he walked out, and the offering was so jam-packed, he could not even close it. I said, Luke, what are you doing? And he said, well, I put all of my money in the wallet. And I don't know, it was maybe $150 or something of that nature. The only issue is it was pretty much all $1 bills. So when you try to stuff that many $1 bills in a wallet, you can't close it. And I said, well, son, what are you doing? And he said, well, Dad, you told us that we're taking an offering tonight, and I'm getting ready for the offering. And I said, are you giving all of your money? And he said, well, no, Dad, I'm not necessarily giving it all, but you got to be willing to give it all just in case God tells you to give it all. You see, so where offerings have to begin with you and me is a willingness to just say, Lord, it's not my money, it's your money. And so I don't have the right to hold on to what you want to give. You know, the book of Romans tells us, you didn't know you were going to get a sermon tonight, did you? Did you? Yeah, you did. You did. You knew. But I'll be brief, all right? But the book of Romans says that God gives. Yeah. You just wait till next Sunday. It's been bottling up all week, man. And so the book of Romans says that God gives to us and God gives through us. So what that means is there are some things. Now, you better listen to this. There are some things God gives to us, but there are some things that God gives to us that are not for us. They're intended to be given through us. In other words, that means there are some things God gives to me that are not for me, but it's for me to be a conduit through which God can use and be a blessing to others. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, you know, what God gives to us, praise the Lord. But what God wants to give through us, may we not hang on to it with clenched fist when God wants it to be a blessing to others. Amen? Preacher, why do you talk so much for offerings? A couple of reasons. Number one, because I want to speak to us the truth of what the Bible says about giving. Amen? That's spiritually. Practically, because I want to give you time to get your money and write your check. So there's a dual purpose. You ready? So what we're going to do, our ushers are going to come. I'm going to pray. We're going to receive our offering. And what we give tonight is going to go directly to Karen Peck and New River to be a blessing to them. And I always try to emphasize that because I want our church to know that when we give offerings to groups or individuals or preachers, we don't hold on to that. That's not ours. That goes to them just like we promise. And all the people said amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the opportunity to give, for what our hearts have already experienced and enjoyed. Speak to us continually. Bless this offering for your glory and honor. And we'll thank you for it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you so much for sowing into the ministry of Karen Peck and New River. It really means a lot to us that your pastor emphasizes giving that much. You don't always hear that. I know you know that. So thank you so much. I just really quickly want to tell you what we have at the table. Our table is also a huge part of what we do. And we have a brand new album tonight that doesn't come out until the end of next month through all of the streaming and downloaded services. So we have hard copies on CD tonight. It's called Lift His Name, and we want everyone here to go home with this project. So we have a Conroe, Texas special tonight. Last night it was the Alba, Texas special. We got to make it personal, people. So you get this album. Our CDs are normally $15 for one, but tonight you can get two CDs for $20. And we are including our Hope for All Nations album with this bundle. And we love this album. Literally changed our ministry. We released this in 2017. And it has taken us to Israel twice. It's taken us to Honduras twice. It's taken us to Northern Ireland. I mean, this album really has changed us, especially our hearts for missions, getting to see these third world countries in Central America. And this album was also nominated for a Grammy Award in 2018. And we were in the same category as Reba McEntire. Yeah. Oh. You can wonder who won the category. But it was an honor to be recognized by the Recording Academy for this album. So you get that Grammy-nominated album with our brand-new Lift His Name album tonight for $20. So we want everyone here to take that package home with you. I think this brand-new album is special. And I told Mom that whenever, I told the whole group that when they got done tracking all the vocals, I said, this is really a special project, and I think people are going to really be blessed from this album. So you get that, and we even have some t-shirts tonight. We're doing a closeout on our Karen Peck and New River t-shirts. So all of the t-shirts for Karen Peck and New River are $10 tonight. And this is our Karen Peck and New River t-shirt. And I love the shirt because I designed this shirt. I've been telling everybody, this shirt is so soft. And I've been challenging everybody that we come in contact with. If you wear a medium, by all means, get a medium. No one's going to judge you for that. But I challenge you, if you wear a medium, come out there and get a small and let that fabric hug you. Nobody cares but you, I promise. So we have those out there. And as Mom said, my wife and I do own a coffee roastery, and we roast fresh coffee every single week. And so we have a nutty coffee from Guatemala, and we also have a fruity coffee from Ethiopia that's actually a rare coffee. It tastes like blueberry. So if you like coffee, come out there and check that out. And we even have a coffee shirt that says, a day without coffee is like, just kidding, I have no idea. So people have been loving that shirt. I've been telling everybody it sells like hotcakes at a Weight Watchers convention. People love it. And we even have a coffee hoodie out there that says, I love Jesus and coffee. And it's a pre-shrunk soft hoodie. So we have those back there as well. So, and if you've, have, are you enjoying Karen Peck and River so far tonight? Really quick, if you've enjoyed us tonight, we are using an app called Bands in Town. And I know Mark Trammell was here earlier in the week, and they too are using this app. But it's called Bands in Town, and it's 100% free. You just download it to your phone and sign in either through your email address or your Facebook account and follow all of your favorite groups. And whenever we book concerts in your area, it sends you a notification letting you know where we're going to be. So it's great, especially for churches like this that put on concerts. It keeps people in the surrounding area in the know of what's going on. So that's something for you to think about. Thank you.
And Yana, well, there you go. How about it for Matthew? So I was just informed by my friends, the Tallies, that down here, I didn't know. Y'all, I'm sorry, but we've been Georgia fans, and so now Georgia's out of the playoffs, and I didn't know this. We got LSU color bags here tonight. So there you go. I think that's just prophetic right there, y'all. Tomorrow night's going to be a good night for y'all. So there, sorry, Fred. I heard. So we want to do a song for you. Well, matter of fact, I'm on the board of directors for Abraham Productions. We do several events a year. Singing in the Sun is coming up this coming April. We'd love for y'all to come to Singing in the Sun in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Y'all, it starts on, I think it's April the 20th through the 25th. We have Dr. David Jeremiah, Jensen Franklin, Herb Revis, C.T. Townsend, a lot. Oh, y'all, it's wonderful. We'd love for you to come to the beach. Then we take the same scenario and we go to the mountains in Gatlinburg. In August, we have brochures in the back. We also, Karen Peck and New River, we have a homecoming this coming June, June the 11th through the 13th. We have, it's literally on our property. We build a stage that looks like an old church. So you bring your lawn chair. It's just a beautiful place. And we have Triumphant Quartet, Jason Crabb, Emily Ann Roberts of The Voice, Joseph Habedank, and Brian Freeney insurance. We'd love for y'all to come and be with us that week as well. And we go on cruises. We're going, to, as I said, to Israel this coming June. We'd love for y'all to go with us. And so that's it. That's our commercial. So there you go. We want to do a song. We're not going to keep you much longer. We want to do a song for you that the Isaacs, Becky Isaacs, Sonia, and Sonia's husband, Jimmy, we were coming off of the second Israel trip, and I was at their home, and I said, I'd love to write a song that we could sing about, and just honestly, from our experience from Israel, I want us to write something that's powerful, and this is really what came out of that. We knew the day we wrote this that it was going to be special. It's on that brand new CD Matthew was talking about. I hope this will bless your heart. Amazed that the God of the universe loves me and knows me by name. I'm overwhelmed that the voice of creation speaks to my heart just the same. He tells the winds when to breathe and be still. He calms my heart when nothing else will. The God that I serve is a God Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, and all who believe. He is the Lamb and the Light of Jerusalem, Bethlehem's Holy One, Messiah, my King. Master and ruler of heaven and earth, that's the God I serve. Is the hope for the broken, the lamb for the lost, lonely soul. He suffered the weight of our sin on Mount Calvary, and by his stripes we are made whole. Why should I worry when trouble is near? He's my deliverer. Jacob and Isaac and all who believe. He is the Lamb and the Light of Jerusalem, Bethlehem's Holy One, Messiah, my King. Master and ruler of heaven and earth, that's the God I serve. I serve. Deliverer, he is alive. The God that I serve is the God of Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, and all who believe. He is the Lamb and the Light of Jerusalem, Bethlehem's Holy One, Messiah, my King. Master and ruler of heaven and our most requested songs right now.
I don't know if I will ever understand it. Why life always happens like it does. Even though I know we're only here for a while, how how come it never seems like long enough? I don't know just when my time is coming. Still I know God has a plan for me and for you. I don't know what leaving looks like, but I know this. You won't have to wonder where I'll be. Jesus promised He would prepare. It's beyond imagination, all the glories we will share. And I know I'll be there. I don't know what kind of mansion God's preparing. Streets of gold I know I'm gonna find. All the pain and suffering that comes in this life, it won't be long, I'll leave it.
But you're 4 days late.
so long. But His way is God's way, not yours or mine. And isn't it great when He's 4 days late, He's still on time. Jesus said, show me the grave. But she said, Lord, you don't understand. He's been there 4 days. The gravestone was rolled back. Then Jesus cried, Lazarus, come forth. Then somebody said, He's alive. Friend, don't be discouraged, 'cause He's still the same. He'll soon be here. He'll roll back the stone and He'll call out your name. When He's 4 days late and all hope is gone, why you're waiting so long. But His way is God's way, not yours or mine. Oh, and isn't it great when He's 4 days late, He's still on time. Oh, my God is great when He's 4 days late, He's still on time.
We want to thank you so much, Pastor. Thank y'all so much for having us here tonight. What a joy it is to be here, to be blessed all day long. But there's no way that we could ever just come and sing a bunch of songs and then say, okay, see you later. But we believe in prayer. And God has been so faithful to us over the years. I cannot begin to tell you the many times that the Lord has come through for us. Just this past Christmas. Whew. My husband Ricky went for tests. I don't tell this everywhere we go, but he went for some tests and having trouble with his arm. And after 4 MRIs since summer, they told us about 3 weeks ago that they were, you know, there were not good things that the doctor was saying. Usually a doctor will not tell you. You know, they'll just do the test and then tell you. And so for 48 hours, it was just agony. And honestly, we just literally cried out to the Lord for mercy. And I can tell you that they told us that on the final exam, they said this could take, because of Christmas was the next week. And so that's just the way Satan works, though. He always gets it. It seems like before we go on vacation or before something, just so we'll just worry. And I know I'm not supposed to worry. I know that. I know what Matthew chapter 6 says. Jesus said, do not worry. And I know that in my heart. And so anyway, they told us, they said that the results of these tests, probably it'll take, you know, it takes 2 days at least for the test to come back. But because of Christmas, it could be a week before you'll know anything or over. And so Ricky went and had the test. And while he was having the test, we just prayed on the way there. We just said, God, we need your help. We need you. And so as I was sitting there in that waiting room, I just felt such a peace come over me. I knew that whatever happened, God just find us faithful. And so Ricky had the test, and we had gone to eat and we were at a restaurant, and y'all, it was less than an hour, the doctor was calling. And the doctor, when Ricky said hello, and he said, "Ricky, I'm having a good Christmas. No tumors, no cancer." And we were so thankful that we cried right there in that restaurant. And I was praising the Lord. I said, "Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus." We were so happy. And then I thought, why am I surprised? Why do we pray for things and then when things happen, we're surprised? We shouldn't be surprised, because that's the goodness of the Lord. And we know that some of you here tonight, maybe you haven't had a good experience. We've been there. We know what it's like to be on the other side of that too with our dad. And so, but through it all, God is faithful. And if it's okay with y'all, I know we're a little bit, I'm going a little bit over. But could we get y'all to stand? And you've been in prayer and preaching and music all week long. And I said, this morning we were talking. I said, we're going to wind this thing down. And then I said, no, we're going to wind it up. So could we have an altar service? Could everybody just come out? And if you're visiting, please feel free. I mean, just everybody, if you would. I love to have an old-fashioned camp meeting altar service. I love that. I love it when we all come to the front and pray for the second Sunday of the year and of the new decade. I believe that 2020 represents perfect vision. And so we've been praying for a while now. God, help us to see clearly your will in our lives and in our ministry. And that's what, can we come down? Will everybody just step out into the aisles? Let's come down. Let's end this week. We're going to begin a new week tomorrow, but can we just end this beautiful week for all of you and just thank the Lord for the many people that have been blessed this week, for the many sermons, for all the preachers that have preached the word. I thank the Lord for a pastor here at Mims that preaches the word. Never heard a message in my entire life, ever heard a better message on giving than we heard tonight. I wish I could bottle it up and just listen to it often. But thank the Lord for people that love Jesus and show Jesus in their lives and their daily walk. And so here tonight, we just speak blessings over every one of you and your family. How many have family members that need to be saved? Our hands are up as well. We just pray that this next decade, as we go into the new year, that God is going to save those loved ones, that God is going to just put a hedge of protection around those kids as well. And for the family members who are out in the world, God, we just pray that that God will bring them into the fold. And that he will set them on fire, because I've always said that if we will fall in love with Jesus, we will never have to worry about anything. That's the truth. When it's all said and done, we can know that our kids will be safe if they love Jesus. Father, we thank you for every person that's here tonight. We thank you for all of the staff here at the church, from the lighting crew to the sound to the music, the choir, all of the ushers, God, and the deacons and the pastor's wife, and all of the music people and administrations. And God, we just pray right now, God, that you continue to pull them together as they are. And Lord, we pray that you will break these walls out, God. I see great things for Mims, God. I thank you that there's freedom to worship. And Lord, for every person that's praying for those family members, Lord, we thank you that this is the year of salvation for those family members, God. For those who are sick in body, God, we thank you for healing them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. And God, we thank you for continuing to show us your will. Help us to see clearly your will in our lives, Lord. We thank you. We thank you for answered prayers in Jesus' name. And while heads are still bowed, I'm on a roll here, y'all, so hang with me. But the Bible says the anointing breaks the yoke and lifts the burdens. And there's such an anointing here tonight. And I thank the Lord. We all thank the Lord for the burdens that have been lifted here tonight. There could be some of you that came that didn't feel like coming. You really did not want to come, but you felt like you wanted to support the church, or maybe a friend. You promised a friend you would come. But I really believe because you moved, because you're standing, because you walked, because you clapped your hands, I believe believe that that has activated your faith here tonight. So whatever you've been believing the Lord for, you just walk in that victory in Jesus' name. And while heads are still bowed and no one's looking, the most important thing of the night, the most important question is, are you sure that you're saved? Please do not go into this next decade and this new year not knowing. Don't go another year, another time of not knowing for sure if you're saved. You don't have to wonder where you're going to be when you're dead and gone, but you can be sure that you're saved. And the Bible says the only way we get to heaven is through the blood of Jesus, that if we believe on Jesus, we shall be saved. And so don't let Satan tell you, well, what will people think? I'll tell you what they'll think. They'll rejoice and they'll say, thank you, Jesus, for making it right. So while no one's looking but us, we're not going to embarrass you or call you out. Or are you sure you're saved? If you're not sure and you'd like to slip up your hand, we're not going to call you out. We're just going to pray. Would you just slip up your hand and say, Karen, I don't know. I really don't know for sure, but I know I need to make things right. I don't want to miss heaven. Would you slip up your hand and put it right back down? Put it up high and put it right back down. Is there anybody here tonight? Anybody? While we wait, is there anybody? We don't see any hands, but I'm going to say the sinner's prayer because the Lord laid this on my heart many years ago to say the sinner's prayer just in case. We didn't see any hands, but there could be someone that raised your hand, or maybe you didn't raise your hand and you felt a conviction on your heart and you want to be sure you're saved. We don't want to leave you out. So if you'll just bow your head and just pray in your heart, dear Jesus, I realize that I'm a sinner and I can't save myself, but I know you can save me. Come into my heart, forgive me of my sins, and save me. And from this day forward, I will not doubt my salvation, and I will trust you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for securing me a place in heaven. And thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul. And while heads are still bowed, the Bible says we're supposed to confess the Lord Jesus. We're not to be ashamed of what he does in our hearts and in our lives. But if you have been doubting your salvation, you had a conviction on your heart, and you feel like you settled your salvation here tonight, would you slip up your hand and say, I really, really made things right here tonight. I settled my salvation. Is there anybody here while we wait? Anybody? Well, Father, we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Okay, now while we're here, y'all, does anybody have anything, just one line you'd like to share? Anybody? Yes. Amen. I believe you're going to be a staple in this church. You're going to be a mighty warrior in this church. God's got great... Y'all see those goosebumps in my arm? You're going to be a great asset to this church. Boy, you've come to the right place. for you. Yes. We praise, we thank the Lord for your ministry. Amen. Anybody else? Anybody else? We love y'all in the balcony too. I know it would take a while for y'all to get down here, but y'all are precious up there. If the Lord comes back, y'all be the first to go. Y'all go before. Okay, y'all, I'm sorry. I should just let it go, you know. Anybody else? Anybody else? Yes. New beginnings. That Bible conference, that right there has started this church on fire. These people are on fire. What a way to start a year. Woo. And a decade. Start a decade. Anybody else? Amen. We thank the Lord you stay well and healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the next checkup to be clear in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, y'all. Well, amen. Well, y'all, let's everybody sing. Well, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. And when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. And everybody said, amen. Come on.
Thank you so much. Wasn't this a blessing? Hey, you don't have to go back to your seat. Just stand there, and I'll close us from here. Thank you so much for being here tonight and for all week. It's been such a blessing. Make sure you go back to their table and visit with them. And if nothing else, get some coffee. Who knows what I'm talking about? And there's a lot of announcements I can make. There's always a lot of announcements to make. You know what? Come back Wednesday. We'll talk more about it. Amen. I love you more than you'll ever know. What a wonderful way to kick off a new year. To whom much is given, much is required. Now let's take it and go do something with it for the glory of God. Amen. I'll see you Wednesday night, church. You're dismissed. God bless you.
It's time to live what we believe. We are God's people. And